our computing power is growing rapidly.
Right.
We create simulations of worlds. We have video games with characters that are inside the video game.
Right.
Imagine a day where you can simulate a world so perfectly with life forms, humans, so well, that you can recreate every single neurosynaptic thought you could have, but now you're in the simulation on the computer.
Remember The Matrix? That groundbreaking movie that delved into post-human thinking and philosophy? In this alternate reality, humanity is trapped within a simulated world, questioning the very fabric of existence. Scientists now suspect it wasn't just fiction. According to astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson, we might be living in a cosmic simulation. And now, the James Webb telescope unravels the truth of our existence. So, are we merely puppets in a digital matrix manipulated by beings from other cosmic worlds? Let's uncover the truth behind this mind-bending simulation.
Are we living in simulation?
I find it hard to argue against that possibility.
Meaning,
you look at our computing power today, and you say, I have the power to program a world inside of a computer. Well, imagine in the future where you have even more power than that, and you can create characters that have, for example, free will, or their own perception of free will.
Have you ever gazed at the night sky, pondering if our reality is more than meets the eye? Could it be that we are but players in an incredibly sophisticated digital realm, a grand cosmic video game crafted by higher beings? This mind-bending concept of living in a simulated universe has fascinated scientists, philosophers, and thinkers for decades. At first glance, the idea might seem like something out of science fiction, but it's not easily dismissed. In 2003, the philosopher Nick Bostrom introduced his groundbreaking simulation theory, sending shockwaves through the scientific community. His theory proposes that an advanced post-human society has the capability to create complex artificial realities using unimaginably powerful supercomputers. And we might be the unwitting participants in this cosmic simulation. Imagine beings so technologically evolved that they've transcended human limitations, delving into realms of existence beyond our comprehension. With their vast intelligence, they could construct a simulated world that is indistinguishable from reality. Every sensation, every interaction, every emotion that we experience might be nothing more than an intricate play of code, skillfully crafted to deceive us into believing that our lives are genuine. But what does this mean for our understanding of truth and reality? If our world is an elaborate simulation, how can we discern what is real and what is an illusion? The very fabric of our existence becomes enigmatic, blurring the line between the tangible and the virtual. As we venture deeper into this philosophical labyrinth, we encounter the concept of transhumanism. Post-humans, as they are called, would represent the epitome of technological evolution. Possessing cognitive and physical abilities far beyond our own, they might be the architects of our simulated universe. Like us, they value progress, reason, and science, but their advanced state allows them to harness technology to enhance their cognitive capacities.
Now, you're a character in that world and you think you have free will. I want to invent a computer, so you do. Hey, I want to create a world in my computer. And then that world creates a world in its computer. And then you have simulations all the way down. So now you lay out all these universes and throw a dart. Which of these universes are you most likely to hit? The original one that started it, or the countless simulations, the daughter simulations that unfolded thereafter?
Transhumanism envisions a future where technology enables us to transcend the limitations of our current human condition. The idea of superhuman abilities, enhanced cognition, and even immortality captivates our imaginations. While we've made significant technological strides, philosopher Nick Bostrom suggests that we are still in the early stages of human evolution. For transhumanism to emerge, much more awaits us on the horizon. At the heart of the matter lies Bostrom's simulation theory, which posits that our reality might be an artificially constructed simulation created by an advanced post-human civilization. In this scenario, our world is not what it seems, and our entire existence could be nothing more than an intricate play of code, masterfully designed to deceive us into believing it is real. The implications of Bostrom's simulation theory are profound and unsettling. If our lives are part of a simulation, do we truly have free will? What happens when the simulation ends? Could there be higher powers, akin to gods or overseers, controlling our destiny? Debates surrounding this idea delve into the realm of philosophy, metaphysics, and epistemology. Ancient questions about the nature of existence, the meaning of life, and the existence of a higher purpose resurface with renewed vigor. While Bostrom's theory remains speculative, it encourages us to explore the limits of our understanding and to question the very foundation of our reality. The simulation hypothesis challenges us to grapple with the boundaries of human consciousness and the vastness of the cosmos. As we delve deeper into the realms of transhumanism and the simulation theory, we find ourselves confronted with profound questions about the nature of our reality and the potential evolution of humanity. These concepts, once relegated to science fiction, are now gaining traction in the scientific and philosophical communities, prompting us to reevaluate our understanding of existence.
Okay. So, and we went to the moon. It's okay. Let's make sure the moon is there.
Right. Okay. Maybe that's why we can't travel faster than the speed of light, because if we could, we'd be able to get to another galaxy.
To explore these ideas further, scientists have long sought tools to observe the cosmos and gain a deeper understanding of our universe's origins. Enter the James Webb Space Telescope, a marvel of human engineering and innovation. This groundbreaking telescope allows us to peer into the ancient depths of space, revealing galaxies that align with the timeline of the Big Bang. The discovery of galaxies as old and mature as our own challenges our previous assumptions about the early stages of the universe. It leads us to wonder if other cosmic civilizations had a head start in their evolution, reaching stages of technological prowess that we can barely comprehend. And if they had the means to create simulations, could we be living in one? This intriguing convergence of transhumanism, the simulation theory, and the JWST discoveries leaves us contemplating the possibilities. Are we destined to evolve into transhumans, harnessing technology to transcend our current limitations? Could we be the creation of an advanced civilization, their simulated reality playing out like an elaborate cosmic experiment? Tech visionary Elon Musk has voiced his belief in the simulation hypothesis, suggesting that our late cosmic birth could put us at a disadvantage compared to other civilizations that had more time to advance technologically. These thought-provoking ideas force us to confront our place in the vastness of the cosmos and the mysteries that lie beyond our understanding. However, as we traverse this intellectual landscape, we must acknowledge the limits of our knowledge. While these concepts captivate our minds and spark lively debates, definitive answers remain elusive. The journey to unraveling the enigma of our existence has just begun, and it is one that may lead us to new frontiers of knowledge and self-discovery. The popularization of the multiverse of madness and the simulation theory has sparked widespread interest and debate across various fields of study. At the heart of this concept lies the idea that our reality might not be as concrete as it seems. Rather, it could be a highly sophisticated simulation created by advanced beings or superhumans. In this scenario, the multiverse is an expansive web of simulations, each existing with its own unique set of laws and inhabitants. These cosmic entities, possessing unimaginable power, could be engaged in a cosmic power struggle, seeking dominance and control over their simulated worlds. To achieve this, they may strategically manipulate resources, introduce challenges, and observe the outcomes of their simulations, much like players in an intricate video game.
So now that world evolves and they develop computing power.
Right.
And they say, we want to play video games.
So now we're going to make a world.
So then they make a world and they have sufficient computing power that they invent
right.
to create a whole universe within their computers.
Okay.
And then
they make a world.
And then they make a world all the way on down.
Right.
It could be hundreds, thousands, billions, infinite.
If we are living in such a simulated reality, it leads to profound philosophical and existential questions. Are our experiences and emotions genuine, or are they merely programmed responses within a complex digital framework? Does the concept of free will hold any meaning if our every action is predetermined by the underlying code? This idea also sheds light on the long-standing Fermi paradox, which wonders why we have not encountered extraterrestrial civilizations despite the vastness of the universe. If our universe is a mere simulation, then the absence of alien contact could be explained by the fact that other simulated civilizations, like ours, have no real incentive to interact with each other. If you want to know more about the Fermi paradox, we have a full video on our channel breaking down this mind-blowing concept. Moreover, the notion of cosmic imperialism arises, suggesting that superhuman entities may be vying for supremacy over their respective simulations. Our world, with its intricacies and complexities, might be just one of countless simulations in the multiverse. Perhaps Earth is the easiest to simulate due to its rich history and the wide array of interactions among its inhabitants. The motive behind running such simulations raises intriguing questions. Why would these advanced beings invest vast amounts of time and resources to create and maintain such a complex digital realm? Some speculate that it may be akin to the thrill we derive from playing video games, wherein we control virtual worlds and characters. For these superhumans, our reality might be their ultimate form of entertainment. To break free from the confines of this cosmic video game, some scientists propose harnessing the power of quantum computing. Quantum mechanics offers the potential to explore new realms and realities beyond our current understanding. However, such a feat would require significant advancements in technology and a race against ever-advancing superhumans. In the end, the notion of living in a simulated reality challenges our perceptions of existence and the very nature of reality itself. It prompts us to question the authenticity of our experiences and the extent of our free will. The multiverse of madness continues to captivate our minds, leaving us to ponder the ultimate question: are we the architects of our destiny, or are we merely characters in an advanced cosmic video game? Share your views in comments, like, subscribe, and watch more content like this here.